back to the land of East Coast racism, a city known for their baked beans and basketball fans living off of the glory of their 20th century championships. As the Boston Celtics look to take the floor and stop their losing streak following their first consecutive loss of the playoffs, in a win or go home scenario, will their forever young 19-year-old phenom Jason Tatum rise to the occasion, or will the dynasty be restored as the Golden State Warriors look to close out the series in six and add a seventh championship banner in the Chase Center and capture their fourth championship in 8 years? In a series where family legacy is clearly on display, what will be the fate of tonight's matchup? Excuse you, motherfucker. Just gonna cough during the damn intro? What's wrong with you? I ought to throw out my Dominican cigars, but them shit's good, so I ain't gonna do it. I forgive you, brother, but don't you ever do that shit again.
Eat a dick, old man.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Hold My Nugget Studios once again, live from TD Garden for Game 6 of your 2022 NBA Finals game.
I like commentary.
The game just started and this senior citizen already getting harassed? Might I add, after game one, did they put him on life support or some shit? This old timer emptied the entire tank in game one. It's a series, not a championship game. I know you were there in person for the Battle of Gettysburg, but that didn't win the war. It just turned the tides. There were still more battles to be fought. Get it together, you old bag of bones.
Eat a dick, old man.
The elderly Horford would get the scoring started from the free throw line, but Draymond Donkey Green puts in 2 points. Back on the other end of the floor, Jaylen Brown puts in a jumper right in Otto Porter Chamberlain's face. Then the smartest Marcus puts in a floater on top of Draymond Green. Jaylen Brown puts in a three in front of Klay Thompson. Then Jason Tatum adds a three of his own in front of Porter. They taking turns all over the Warriors.
What is your name?
That's my dad.
Who's your daddy? Who's your daddy?
Let that motherfucker go right there and shit.
Did I stutter?
Game just started. Warriors has as many points as turnovers, and the Celtics went on a 10-0 run. The Celtic lead increases to 12, but Andrew Wiggins puts in a three. Klay PBS logo in the face. Thompson rattles in a two. The disappearing Derek White puts in a layup to try to cut the Warriors' run, but Thompson puts in another three. And Steph Curry adds a two. The deficit is down to six. Did Jordan Poole just glitch his way to a basket? Look at his right leg. Why did he hop into the contact like that? Was he trying to bait his way into a call? He could have tore his ACL. Buddy pressed the wrong button on his controller, but Jaylen Brown adds a two. Tatum would add another two. The lead is up to six. Why is Draymond shooting threes? He hasn't made one all series.
I cannot believe it.
I apologize for my outburst.
Steph Curry puts in a circus shot. Golden State's in front. But they wouldn't stop there. Jordan Poole spots a baddie in the front row, banks in a three, and the Warriors end the first quarter on an 11-0 run. And if you consider the last 8 minutes, a 25-8 run, they finish the quarter with how many points?
27.
Into the second quarter we go, and the Warriors offense looking like a rigged game of pool. Ain't nothing missing. Jordan Billiards puts in two threes, Wiggins adds a couple of twos, and the Warrior lead is up to 15. They're on a 21-0 run in less than 2.5 minutes. The longest single NBA Finals run over the course of the last 50 years.
How do you do that? How do you do that? What the hell is going on?
Jaylen Brown finally says,
enough is enough. This bullshit has got to stop. Things are going to have to change around here.
Scores two baskets, cuts the deficit to 10, and now the Celtics have
27.
Wait a minute. You could have saw this video early and ad-free. All you got to do is click the link in my description or go to patreon.com/chiseledadonis and become a level 3, 4, 5, or 6 member. And you won't have to worry about ads, and you'll see this before everybody else. What are you waiting for?
But Curry would respond.
Get shit out of here, nigga.
7-0 run to cut the deficit down to 8. Here come the Celtics. I could have swore I seen this brother selling mangoes by the airport in Atlanta. I might be wrong. Look at the scoring runs we've had tonight. If there's one thing about this 2022 Boston team in the postseason, they gonna give up a run and they gonna have a run of their own. Thompson puts in a jump shot. Williams responds with a dunk. You wearing a big ass chain with them big ass earrings? Change the camera angle. Let's see what else is big. Once again, the Warriors look to go on a run to close out the second quarter. Wiggins rattles in a three.
We do not care.
We need to form a prayer circle around Robert Williams. That brother gotta have some hate in his heart with the way he be hitting these basketballs. Steph Curry puts in a floater. The lead is up to 13, but old man Horford with a two.
Gotcha, bitch.
Derek White falls for the pump fake. Curry puts in a three. Then Draymond would add another. Looks like that first three was a fluke.
You got me now, or you figured me out. You got me red-handed.
But despite his offensive struggles, his Golden State Warriors cannot be stopped, and what was once an 8-point deficit has turned into an 18-point deficit for Boston again. Only the Celtics can give up two double-digit runs in the same quarter, and they got 11 turnovers in the first half. They losing by 21. They went up by 12 within the first 4 minutes of this game, and they got cocky or something. Bruh, you gotta relax.
How about new?
Williams getting it done on both ends of the floor, but the Warriors go into the break with a 15-point lead. In the last 20 minutes, Boston got outscored 52-25. That's a difference of how many points?
27.
27. 27.
27.
Incept. Teams up by 15 plus at halftime on 53-1, with the only loss being Game 3 of the 2008 NBA Finals when the Lakers blew a 24-point lead against the Celtics. Can they recapture that same magic? Draymond made multiple threes in this game. He ain't done that since April.
You niggas in trouble. You niggas in trouble. You niggas in trouble. Niggas in trouble.
Trailing by 18 again, Jaylen Brown gets inside for the layup. Old man Horford puts in a three.
That is my son.
Eat a dick, old man.
How does Steph Curry get this wide open? Puts in a three. Time for Tatum to respond. Leave it to the elderly to show the young whippersnappers how to make a three. The Celtics disrespectful. Look how much space they gave Otto Porter Chamberlain as he made this three. The smartest Marcus answers with a two. Steph Curry don't give a shit. He adds another three. Witness of Jesus Christ crucifixion, Al Horford adds his third three of the quarter. But Otto Porter Chamberlain responds. Steph Curry from the finals logo. It's a 22-point lead. You're the second-ranked defense in the NBA playoffs, but you can't get a stop. What does Steph Curry want?
A ring.
Oh, that's
a ring.
Ring.
A ring.
Off of a smartest Marcus brick, Robert Williams gets a tip in. The smartest Marcus puts in a three. The deficit is under 20 points.
Foul, foul.
What happened?
Wait a minute. We stopping the game because Grant Williams got hurt? I say let him bleed out on the ground, that flopping son of a bitch. Kevon Looney didn't even touch him.
He is still one sick, perverse son of a bitch.
That Flopasaurus Rex couldn't sell an injury if he was a 10-year veteran in professional wrestling. Walking around acting like his lips swollen. Nobody touched you.
No good, lousy son of a bitch.
Hey,
that's exactly what he is. But he's a no good bastard for what he did, and he ought to burn in hell for it.
He didn't even catch an elbow. He caught what he believed was the Holy Ghost, but it's really the spirit of Lucifer. They'd go and review to see if it's a flagrant. When you look up the definition of dishonesty, it's this motherfucker's face right here. Look at Looney's elbows. At what point did they contact this man's face? He over here looking like he got shot in a 1940s African movie.
He's gonna rot in hell for what he did here tonight. That just makes me sick. Face. How in God's name can that human being be from this planet? How many? Does he have no conscience? Does he have no heart? Do you have no soul? You son of a bitch! Do you realize what you just done?
Though the referees would not see anything that would warrant a flagrant foul, that vermin would flop his way to a Celtics possession and a Jaylen Brown basket. Destroy his ankles, Curry! Make him dance! At least Wiggins got the tipping.
Excuse me, can I talk to you for a minute?
Just write the check and the house is yours. Just put the money in my hand and you won't have to live next to this bunch of stinking niggas.
I want Iguodala.
Iguodala looked like a disappointed father. I don't know what he told Gary Payton to do, but he clearly ain't do it. Junior getting flashbacks right now, and if he think it's bad on the court, just wait until he gets home.
But you got trouble.
Do you need a shout out? Perhaps you need somebody to sing happy birthday for you. Maybe you need some help roasting a friend, or you just need somebody to announce the draft order for your fantasy football league. Book me on Cameo. Go to cameo.com/chiseledadonis and book me today.
Trailing by 17, it's do or die. Jaylen Brown goes on a personal 5-0 run to cut the deficit down to 12. Member of the first five of the Social Security, Al Horford gets an and one, and it's a 9-point game. Jordan Poole to the cup.
Not today.
Bill Russell's kindergarten teacher with a block. The Celtics are on a 15-2 run.
Yeah, well, not anymore, you're not.
Bitch ass, faggot ass, punk ass, pussy ass, bitch ass, nickel. You want to do something, bitch?
Jaylen Brown adds a free throw and we enter the fourth quarter with the Celtics trailing by 10. These two Celtics fans was getting a ton of camera time during the series. It'd be a shame if they took an L.
So what's the game plan for the fourth quarter?
How the hell can I answer that? I don't know.
Fun fact, if you didn't know, Jason Tatum was scoreless thus far in the second half. The smartest Marcus would penetrate the paint, get himself a layup. The lead is still 10. What a load of malarkey. They call this a foul on Williams. He ain't do nothing wrong. Jordan Poole would put in two free throws. The lead's back to 12. And Jordan Billiards would not stop as he'd add a reverse layup. The lead is up to 14. After 15 minutes of second half play, Tatum finally has a basket. It'd be a real shame if he never scored again. Not that that's gonna happen, right?
Come here.
Payback's a bitch.
Witness the might of the Jabari. First time!
Draymond's open in the corner! I heard the ref say if he made that, they would have brought out the trophy right now. Tatum with a brick inside. Steph Curry glides inside and gets two right in front of Jaylen Brown's face, so he'd respond with a smooth two of his own.
You gotta be kidding me.
No, not this way! No, damn it! Not this way! Not this way! Damn it!
You bastard! You freak! You monster! Damn his soul!
I hate you, man.
That low-life Grant Williams got an and one, but Steph Curry responds with a layup. What the hell is Jason Tatum doing? Jaylen Brown puts in a three, but Wiggins says right back at you, pussy. And the donkey has double digits.
Old man Horford
puts in a three, but he gets put into a blender by Steph Curry. Another basket for Golden State. And now the light-skinned assassin got how many points?
27.
Tatum must have had his powers taken away by the Nerdlux. This man out here traveling with 3:32 left to go. The game is on the line, stupid.
27.
Just in case you forgot, Steph Curry got how many points?
27.
Not for long, because Horford went flying by his face, puts in another three, another 30-piece for Curry as he tells the crowd, it's sleep time. Look at Tatum, like an amputee with the urge to masturbate. He don't know what to do. He couldn't buy a basket even if it was Easter. It's been all Jaylen Brown and Al Horford for the Celtics fourth quarter long, but Andrew Wiggins keeps responding. 90 seconds left to play. Steph Curry adds a couple of free throws.
Took a nap. You ever go night-night, nigga? You ever go night-night, nigga? Everybody go night-night, nigga.
Damn, they sending the scrubs in.
What the fuck, y'all?
Reality starting to set in for Steph Curry, realizing that the dynasty continues. Jason Tatum clearly paying tribute to his son, going out there in the second half only scoring deuce. You only had 2 points.
When the world needed him most, he vanished.
What's wrong? Where's your strength? Where is your pride?
A couple more free throws for Curry.
I want Iguodala.
On the floor for the final moments as the buzzer sounds, a 13-point victory. And the Golden State Warriors have done it. Hey! Hey, don't you embrace that piece of garbage! Get that bastard off the screen at once!
Fuck you, bitch!
Nevertheless, the Golden State Warriors have returned back to the throne injuries robbed them from. Led by coach Steve Kerr, one of the 15 greatest coaches of all time. 9 total championships, 5 as a player, 4 as a head coach. Former number 1 overall pick Andrew Wiggins, deemed a successful bust, never living up to the expectation, but put it all on the line in the postseason, and now an NBA champion. The anchor, Draymond Donkey Green, often overlooked and overcriticized, guaranteed first ballot Hall of Famer, one of the greatest basketball IQs in NBA history, future TNT analyst, and now 4-time champion, Clay PBS. Yes, logo in the face Thompson, overcoming a 2-year absence, fighting through adversity, knee injuries, Achilles injuries, stepping back on the court 6 months ago, now a 4-time champion and their ringleader, the only unanimous MVP in NBA history, 2 times the league's most valuable player in a season of the ages, becoming the all-time leader in 3-pointers made after passing Ray Allen, considered by casual as an underachiever in the NBA Finals, and finally, after 6 attempts, he is a Finals MVP and a 4-time champion. The Golden State Warriors did it before KD, with KD, and after KD, as Klay Thompson, Draymond Green, and Steph Curry would cement themselves as the greatest trio in NBA history.
Holy cannoli, this is crazy.
Capturing their 7th championship in franchise history. Your 2022 NBA champion, Golden State Warriors, would take out their Metro card and get aboard the W train.
You win.
Congratulations.
Well done. Superb. Excellent. Pay your respects. There is a new king. You are the king of the hill. First place.
Congratulations! Oh my god.
But for the Boston Celtics.
Don't it make you sad about it?
Celebrating to be on TV? Boston Celtics! You were riding high in the NBA Finals, leading 2-1 at the conclusion of Game 3, allowed Steph Curry to smile and go on to lose 3 consecutive games. You too fell victim to the Kendrick Lamar album curse.
To this day, we still thought if we went to the championship instead of LeBron and those guys, we definitely would be Golden State that year.
Much, much, much later.
What are they gonna say now? What are they gonna say now?
1, 2, 3, 4 rings in my bank account, bitch.
You thought you was winning championship number 18? You let this discount, great value, holiday sale, reincarnated without the talent, Wilt Chamberlain, Otto Porter Chamberlain, get a championship on your heads. This nincompoop tattooed the 2022 world champion Boston Celtics on his arm, and now he gotta get laser tattoo removal, cause you nincompoops packed it in. And last but not least, Jason Tatum! You had the nerve, the audacity to text Kobe Bryant's number before Game 7 of the Eastern Conference Final talking about I got you today. But what about the NBA Finals, Jason? I thought that was the goal. Kobe would be disappointed because the only tribute you gave him was losing 2-4 in the series. You're the first man in NBA history to have 100 turnovers in a single playoff run. You put up 2 points in the second half of a game you had to win.
I was rooting for you. We were all rooting for you out
this. You go to bed at night, you lay there, and you take responsibility for yourself. Because nobody's going to take responsibility for you.
Put your motherfucking head back down, because you and your Boston Celtics would be taking out your Metro cards and getting aboard the L train. But your ride would be short-lived, because you've arrived at Elimination Station and you go somewhere different for your failures of blocking the Golden State Warriors dynasty from being rejuvenated, your failures of stopping teams throughout the entire postseason of going on double-digit runs at your behest, your failures of capitalizing on the performances of Jaylen Brown and Al Horford. Consider your names written down the death note, because your dreams of forcing a game seven, your dreams of lifting the Larry O'Brien championship for the second time this side of the millennium, your dreams of passing the LA Lakers for the most titles in NBA history has been absolutely deleted.
There's only one thing left to do. Gotta write their names in the death note.
Delete.
Delete, delete, delete.
Delete.
Delete, delete,
delete. Delete.
Delete,
delete, delete.
Delete, delete,
delete.
Delete.
Deletion.
Deleted.
Hawkeye.
Okay.
You will rest in peace.
Hope you like it hot. Introducing Ruffles.
Fresh hot ales.
You mean to tell me you watched the entire video but you haven't subscribed? Hit the subscribe button and become a member on Patreon or on YouTube to get access to the Discord. We're waiting for you in the Shadow Realm.
Do it! Just do it! Make your dreams come true!
Please! Please!
What are you waiting for, huh?
Oh my God.